Things Heard and Seen, a new horror movie starring Amanda Seyfried, follows the Clare family as they move into their new but very haunted home. Paranormal activity begins to escalate quickly. The question is it based on a true story?
You know how these old Hudson Valley homes are? We think we own them, but we're really just caretakers.
Yeah, they outlive us all.
My wife thinks ours is haunted.
Well, she's probably right.
Things Heard and Seen tells the story of Catherine and George Clare, a young couple that moves with their daughter from New York City to the small hamlet of Chosen, New York. While George begins his new job teaching art history at the local college, Catherine starts to renovate the old dairy farm that they've moved into.
Yeah, certainly could use a paint job.
Yeah, but look at these bones.
However, it doesn't take long for things to take a dark turn, in their house and in their marriage. Based on the book All Things Cease to Appear by Elizabeth Brundage, Things Heard and Seen explores the horror of realizing that the only thing scarier than a haunted house may be the person you're married to. From ghost sightings to impossible sounds, George and Catherine eventually feel manipulated by the spirits in the house themselves.
I'm starting to see things, and I'm scared to tell George about it.
A house with a mysterious and violent past? Unexplainable phenomena? A family in danger? This premise is similar to the true events of the Amityville Horror. In December of 1975, the Lutz family moved into a house in Amityville, a town near Long Island, New York. They were able to get a great deal on the place, as a year earlier in November 1974, Ronald DeFeo Jr. had killed 6 members of his family. Soon after the Lutz family moved in, their haunting began. The Lutz family recorded over 45 hours of tape to chronicle their experiences, including 2 failed blessings of their home and voices shouting at them to get out. They moved out in January of 1976, having lasted only 1 month in the house. While there have been many skeptics about the truth of the haunting, the Lutz family still claims their haunting story is true.
I'm afraid this home has another spirit.
While the history of cursed objects covers a wide spectrum, from dolls to cars and everything in between, the most glamorous item to bring bad fortune and imminent death is, hands down, cursed jewelry. One of the most famous diamonds in history, the Hope Diamond, is considered to be particularly cursed. The stone, originally a whopping 112.19 carats, was sold to King Louis XIV of France in 1768. If his name sounds familiar, it's because he was the husband of Marie Antoinette. They were able to enjoy the diamond for a few years before having their heads cut after their subjects revolted in 1783. The Hope Diamond changed hands a few more times, always leaving its owners racked by ruinous debt, including King George IV of England. Despite knowing its cursed history, socialite and heiress Evelyn Walsh McLean bought the diamond in 1909, claiming that unlucky items were lucky for her. This proved incorrect, as in the years after the purchase, her son was killed in a car accident, her daughter OD'd on sleeping pills, and her husband succumbed to brain atrophy brought on by alcoholism. She was forced to sell her family's bankrupt newspaper, the literal Washington Post, before dying of pneumonia in 1947. The stone now resides at the Smithsonian in Washington, D.C., kept safely behind very thick glass to prevent it from wreaking further havoc. Emanuel Swedenborg was a real-life theologian, philosopher, scientist, and mystic. In 1741, Swedenborg began to experience spiritual visions and dreams. The spiritual awakening led him to found the Swedenborg religious movement.
Well, Swedenborg, he wasn't just some mystic. He keenly understood that everything in the natural world has a counterpart in the spiritual realm.
Swedenborg believed that human beings live in both a physical and spiritual world, becoming conscious of the spiritual world when we die.
Myself included, we even have seances on occasion. I'll invite you.
I will bring my wife. She is the true believer of the family.
Stories of people communicating with the dead go back as far as written history, all the way before ancient Greece.
She's reaching out to me, and I need to know why.
However, the term séance, which comes from the French words for session and sit, was not used until the 1800s with the rise of the spiritualist movement. This movement became so popular that even American President Abraham Lincoln's wife, Mary Todd, held séances in the White House. Many in the scientific and religious communities are skeptical of séances, which makes sense. Several famous mediums, including the Fox sisters and the Davenport brothers in the 1850s, have been exposed as frauds. However, there have been unexplained instances of mediums such as Cora Scott Hatch and Arthur Ford channeling spirits through trance mediumship. Even the creator of Sherlock Holmes, Sir Arthur Conan Doyle, was made a believer, saying, "One of the most amazing things I have ever seen in 41 years of psychic experience was the demonstration of Arthur Ford." Whether you agree that seances work or not, many believe that the dead can be spoken to, and seances remain common in modern times.
And remember, evil only thrives in the house where it is welcome.
In the movie, George originally seems to be a loving husband and caring father who only wants what's best for his family. However, in Swedenborgian fashion, truth eventually comes to light that he's not the man he said he was.
How could you not tell me about this house, George?
Oh, Jesus. I was afraid this might happen.
You were afraid that one of your lies would be exposed?
What's he hiding? What does he really want?
George Clare always gets exactly what he wants.
You'll have to watch to find out. Sometimes, truth is stranger than fiction. While things heard and seen might not be based on a true story, it definitely has a basis in reality.
You know what they say about temptation? Easiest way to kill it's just to give in.
What would you do if you thought your house was haunted? Tell us in the comments below, and watch Things Heard and Seen on Netflix now.